Hey Alex, what's up?
Hey Noah, I have a quick question. A customer is looking to learn a little bit more about screen level integration options. Can you show them a quick demonstration of App Enabler in OnBase, please?
Sure, let me share my screen.
Awesome, thank you.
Application Enabler allows us to use our existing line of business application and still access the depth of knowledge stored in OnBase. This HR enterprise solution will be the application that we're using to showcase these capabilities when looking up pertinent employee information. So to use this app, I just need to select my employee and hit search. Once I do, it brings back Ingrid's information within my application. So with App Enabler, I can access information stored in OnBase by interacting with the application screen. So for this example, I'm going to just double click on the screen and it's going to bring back employee documents for Ingrid Thomas. So I could select her I-9 and view the document, but let's take a look at how to configure this. So first I want to launch AE config. This brings up a window to enable a screen for our app. And I'm going to select new smart screen and find a good spot to select by hovering my mouse over, and you'll see the window that it's recognizing outlined with a blue highlight. So once I'm happy, I'll click once to capture the screen. Next, hit the view window tree and right click on the selected line and hit highlight. You'll notice the application will highlight the screen being selected, and you can do this to all the lines in the info tree. But once you're satisfied, right click again and select use selected window. So the name and the caption will be populated. Feel free to modify the name, but the caption, at least that beginning part, should be the same. That's the ID it's looking for. So I'll hit next, and now I'm gonna add document types to gather keywords that App Enabler is going to use. Next, here is the list of keywords associated with those document types. I want App Enabler to find the employee name to be able to search on. So it's gonna open the Finder tool to add to the text box where the employee name is going to be expected to be found. So I'll click and drag over to where I want it and click OK and finish. So here's where you can configure the mouse or keyboard event to kick off retrieving documents or whatever you're going to configure App Enabler to do. And since I wanted to do this when I double click, I'm going to just leave it alone. And lastly, I'm going to navigate to Advanced, select my screen, and hit Settings. Here's where I want to tell App Enabler when a user double clicks in the window and an employee name has been found, please run a custom query for employee documents. So I'll just select the custom query using the drop down here. And this is just one example of what App Enabler can access from OnBase. You can see the selections below could bring back a Unity form, a workflow process, a work view application, and other tabs we could set up folders. So I'll click OK, and then I'll save. And lastly, we want to load the configuration into App Enabler by right-clicking on the OnBase icon in the toolbar and launch the AE toolbar. From here, we can load our saved config file, and then we could see all of the items that are configured in the configuration file here. So that's how users interact with Application Enabler and how admins can configure this for their users.
Hit the subscribe button to stay up to date with all of our free training resources. And make sure that you reach out if you have any questions that you'd like featured in an upcoming episode of The Question Corner.